Hello, welcome to VEGA Talk. In this episode, we are going to discuss the question, how can sensors be protected against cyber attacks? These days, not only do company networks have to be protected, like here in our IT department, but now we also have to think about entire industrial facilities as well. So Jürgen, in light of this, how secure is our latest measurement technology?
Hello, Stefan. The digital world is finding its way into more and more areas of the industry. Everyone wants to be able to have access not just production or measurement data, but also information about the status of the sensors themselves, and if it's possible, from anywhere in the world. This means industrial controlled computers and machines are becoming more and more networked, but this is also making them more vulnerable.
I guess that means that machines need to be protected from cyber attacks and their defenses continuously improved?
You're right. Let's have a closer look on this.
Okay. Jürgen, one question. How do sensors and machines communicate with each other? What is different here compared to the office world?
We are talking about operational technology, short OT, as opposed to IT in the office. Sensors forward their measuring values to gateways and controllers, which in turn collect and send data to operable machines, interfaces, and networks. For example, a distributed control system and display. This data is tied into production and maintenance system, and it can be connected to IT as well.
Does this mean that each instance has its own interfaces and must be secured accordingly?
Exactly. It's important to have an overall security concept. It is a secure system only if you consider all levels.
That's a lot of requirements. What role does this IEC 62443 standard play in all this?
This norm unifies the worldwide security requirements in order to provide security for industrial automation and control systems. Plant builders, plant operators, and component manufacturers like VEGA have a responsibility to protect their individual areas of operation, which then results in a comprehensive security concept. A threat analysis allows any potential vulnerabilities to be identified at the early stage during the sensor development and appropriate countermeasures to be taken in a final product.
So you are saying, if all these points are taken into account from the start, the result is a product that meets the latest security standards. But can a sensor be tampered with at all?
Sensors are delivered locked with a pin, so no one can access the sensor on the way to the customer. Any firmware update is only possible with a special encrypted form, which means that no manipulated software can be installed. Additionally, any attempts to unlock the sensor with an incorrect password is recorded in the sensor.
Are there different levels of security? Sometimes an extra high level of security is not necessary everywhere.
In some cases, it's impossible to get any access to the sensor. For example, if it's located in a secure building which provides full protection. So level 0 is sufficient in these cases. When we have level 1, a password is required. At level 2, we can have each user with their own password. And at level 3 or 4, a two-factor authentication is needed to log in, like you log in your bank account.
It's amazing what VEGA is doing to offer the customer the most secure products possible. To make sure that everything remains secure in the future, a special VEGA team tracks down and quickly eliminates any vulnerabilities that may arise. Thank you, Jürgen.
You're welcome.
And see you next time.